Q&A on CII.
I run a property company that owns both residential and commercial property. We do both the investment as well as the management of said property portfolio. We are unsure on whether it is Sharia compliant to acquire a commercial property whereby a small portion of rental would be coming from the sale of alcohol. An example would be, should we acquire a large mall? Whilst most of the income would be from the usual tenant mix, a portion of an anchor tenant, say, for example, Pick and Pay's rental would be from a Pick and Pay liquor. Our questions are as follows. Number one, are we allowed to acquire such a property? Number two, if yes, what is the allowable percentage for alcohol sales? Number three, if no, are we then also not allowed to have tenants that sell unhalal meat in their shops?
According to Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullahi alayhi, it is permissible for one to rent one's property to a non-Muslim for the purposes of running a church, synagogue, or even selling wine. Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullahi alayhi's viewpoint is based on the premise that one is merely renting out the manafi or the usufruct of the asset to the non-Muslim. One is not responsible nor accountable for the unlawful actions of a non-Muslim. However, according to Imam Muhammad rahmatullahi alayhi, Imam Abu Yusuf rahmatullahi alayhi, and the other three a'imma, that is Imam Malik, Imam Shafi'i, and Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, rahimahumullah, it is not permissible for the lessor or the mujir to rent out his property for such purposes. The first view of Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi is more accommodative, while the view of Sahibain, that is Imam Muhammad and Imam Abu Yusuf, is more in line with taqwa and it is more conscientious. The main issue of discussion is i'anah al-ma'asiyah, and the fuqaha have differed regarding this classification. The ideal ruling would be that one does not rent out one's property for such purposes. If a person has taqwa, if a person has iman and sincere courage, then such a person should abstain from such a rental arrangement. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَعَوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ, and do not assist one another in sin and transgression. In any event, and according to this explanation, the rental income received from such clients will be permitted. However, taqwa will demand that such income must be dispensed of in charity, or what you could potentially do is that the rental income could be swapped for higher maintenance charges in such an event. In such a scenario, you could recover your maintenance costs while not directly charging a rental fee to such a tenant. You are also welcome to contact us at the Darul Iftah for further guidance on structuring a Sharia-compliant rental agreement, and you can read more on Ijara by downloading our book called Your Brief Guide to Islamic Finance from the Sharia-compliant business campaign website called www.shariabusiness.com. Q&A.